Hello and welcome back to the FL Studio Music Production course. This is lesson 8, where we will be learning a new technique for producing beats called sampling. Up until this point, we have created all of our beats from scratch. However, this is not the only way to create music. Some of the biggest tracks of all time were created by taking a portion, or a sample, of a sound recording and reusing it in a different song or piece of music. This can include sampling a beat, melody, or any other sound from an existing recording. Here's a few examples of samples used on hip-hop tracks. That portion of the track was cut out and reversed, which is used in the track called Money Trees by Kendrick Lamar. We also have this track called Psycho Babble. Do just what I tell you. Which was sampled in ASAP Rocky's Ghetto Symphony. In fact, in 2019, 32% of the music in the top 100 charts contained samples. So today, I'm going to show you exactly how the beat for J. Cole's Wet Dreamz was produced from scratch. And then we're going to create our own beat using a sample. Firstly, you can search online for samples that you wish to use. I've used a YouTube MP3 downloader to download this track here, Mariah by Family Circle. Now, we want to set the tempo of the track so that it matches the tempo of the sample. We can use this tempo tapper right here by right-clicking on the tempo and clicking on tap and tapping on each beat as we play the sample. So what we're going to do is press space to play the track whilst left-clicking on the tap tool to figure out the tempo. Right, so from that we could figure out that it's 121 beats per minute. If you're struggling to do this, you can just Google search this if it's a popular song. Now that the tempo of the project matches the tempo of the sample, we can double click into this and change the mode to stretch. This will allow us to play the sample at whichever tempo we change the project to. You'll notice there's a gap at the beginning of the recording. If we turn on the metronome and play this sample, we'll notice that it's not synchronized with the project. So what we're going to do is press Alt and left drag this so that the beats line up with the project. Now if we listen to this, you can see that it's synchronized. Now we're going to pitch the sample up by 6 semitones, or 6 notes, by left click and dragging on the pitch here, and we can see how many semitones is being shifted in the top left hand corner of the screen. 600 cents is equal to 6 semitones or 6 notes. We're also going to increase the tempo to 177 beats per minute. Now we simply need to use the slice tool up here to chop parts of the sample out that we wish to use. In Wet Dreamz, here are where the chops are. There's also one here. This is the first chop that was taken, which is from this part of the track here. Then this chop was repeated again, but slightly shorter this time, and repeated once more. Then this chop up here was taken, then this is shortened to the end of the beat. Then we can left click and drag and press Ctrl and B to duplicate this. This is the first 4 bars of the beat. And actually the last sample is changed slightly. We remove this chop here, elongate this slightly, and then this chop here is taken. And then we shorten this. This is the next chop here. And then finally, this part is added here. Here's how this sounds. Then the beginning four bars are duplicated over, but the next eight bars change slightly, as you'll be able to hear here. Finally, we can also either create our own drum loops or find a drum pattern online and sample this too. In the beat for Wet Dreamz, a drum loop from a track called Impeach the President was used. Here's how this sounds all together. This may seem a little confusing at first, and in truth, there's not a great way of explaining how to sample. Essentially, you have to make chops yourself and listen to what sounds good. There's no right or wrong here. Just make sure that the tempos match when you first drag the samples in, using the tempo tapper tool that we used earlier, and then just use your ear for what sounds good. Now that we've seen how this is done, let's go through the process of creating our own beat using a sample. I've taken this track called Let Go. I then listened to this part of the track where there's drums and worked out that this is 140 beats per minute. Again, you can just Google this to find this out if you're unable to use the tempo tapper. I then used the slice tool to take these chops. I used this part for the intro. I then took this part from later in the track for the verse. Here's how this sounds. And then finally, I opened up the channel rack and added some drums. If you want to copy them down, here's how they look. Here's how this beat now sounds. That's how you create a sample beat from scratch. And that wraps up lesson 8, where you've now learned how to sample music. Again, there's no rights or wrongs for this. Just make sure that you line the tempos up so that the sample matches the project tempo, and it's up to you to make chops that you like the sound of.